They'll try and start this drive in the air. And the Niners get there and bring him down. And it appears we've got a member of the Rams shaken up on that last play. The medical staff will attend to him, and we will step aside. So much for coming out throwing as it leads to an early second down and long. Now back to throw. And that one complete downfield to Cup. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Cup beats the D for a first that time. And it really was a defense who could stop him the last 2 years. Only an ankle injury slowed him down, ending his 2022 season after 9 games. He was on an all-pro pace, and we expect to see the same again this year.
And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
That's an early scrambler that can be viewed positively by either side. From the offensive point of view, it begins to establish him as a possibility to keep it on certain plays. And defensively, they're going to give up a huge play and one of their first tests in containing a quarterback on the run.
Rookie to rookie on the hookup there, and it's a first down.
Second and short, that's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 34. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He's got his target. It's the tight end, Tyler Higbee. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
Well, this is what you want to see from your rookie quarterback on an opening drive, Charles. He looks cool. He looks calm. He looks collected in marching them down the field.
And, Brandon, I just think the game continues to change and evolve because we're calling these guys rookies. But you know, they're throwing the football so much at a younger level now. Way more so than what we saw when guys came into the league when you and I came through.
And also just the way, in particular to him, Charles, how he handles himself in meetings. Just so professional, mature.
And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. It's their quarterback with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Rams. They'll look to throw here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. He'll look to throw. That'll be caught, it's caught. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25.
I know this may be jumping the gun a little bit, but 7-7, they're flinging it around like crazy. Look at the drive that's going on here. Partner, we may have to start thinking about one of these defenses just holding someone to a field goal and maybe trying to get advantage that way.
Counting down toward the midway point in corner one. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw.
Going to be taken in here by Nakua.
That's good. The completion there for 7 yards. And it'll be second down.
And the Rams had 0-1 of the year following the loss in the opener. And listen, they knew last week they were in for a tough fight on the road. But now here's the home opener and a chance to get things right.
And I like the way that you presented that because the bottom line is they didn't come out of that loss discouraged. They just came home and said, hey, if we do what we're supposed to do, protect our home turf, we'll be just fine.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Open man right side is Cup, complete. Touchdown, LA! Cooper Cup, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Rams have taken the lead.
I know these
those wide receivers are about flash and dash and high-flying plays, but a good number of them played running back at some point in their career, and that's how they finish off a lot of their big plays, right after the catch.
And this time he finishes off the big... They begin the drive with Williams. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Javon Hargrave, the former Eagle, there on the stop.
Brandon, one thing about blitzes, they really confuse offensive linemen at times. And what you have to do is lock in on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle end up making the play.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Flush to his right. Shoves him away. Oh, some strong running. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain. He'll drop to throw. And that's caught. It's 2-2 Atwell. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. Give him 30 yards there.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
Kyle Shanahan doesn't care much for that last call, so out comes the right challenge flag. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call. So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, L.A. Puka Nacua with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Rams are able to widen their advantage.
So after the disappointment in the opening week loss, Charles, this looks like really a completely different football team.
They sure do, and I think they realize we can't start 0-2, and they're determined to not let it happen.
They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. Through the middle of the field. Inside the 20. Touchdown, LA! Kyron Williams, his first rushing touchdown of the year. And the Rams are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
I don't think you can get any more efficient or tidy, whatever word you want to use, than that. Man, one play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? Doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up on the whiteboard.
First down, he'll drop to throw. That's caught. Davis Allen. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. And they get 17 more on that one and another first down.
Well, it certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
This one swung out to Williams.
Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout.
So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward. Back to throw now on first down. Eluding the pressure right. Spinning away. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down. Charles, in the past, a lot of people call this offense one-dimensional.
I think you did.
Well,
I think it was you.
I'll be honest, I did. I think the fan base is hoping with this young rookie that they can put some wrinkles in this offense like we just saw.
I think you're exactly right, because we did have that discussion that what we've seen in the past from them, they needed to broaden, and they have done it here. Look at what he's bringing to their offense, and now as a defensive coordinator, you've got some extra work to do to prepare for him and their offense.
It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Rams. Cooper Kupp with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Rams have moved out in front. He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was.
Here we go, sack.
Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Fred Warner, the all-pro linebacker, there on the stop. Now second and nine. They're going to look to throw. Pass caught. It's Ben Skoranek. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. First target, first catch, and a first down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Pass complete there to McCool. And they'll get him down after a pickup of eight, second and two. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Now the throw here complete on the right sideline. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Again, he'll drop to throw. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
He's starting to fall into the category of not fair, because when he's on target throwing the ball, he's dangerous. But when you add in his ability to make plays with his feet, almost impossible.
Yeah, exactly. They've had trouble stopping him in the secondary. This time they've got the great coverage. Oh, he can run too. So the completion good for seven there, and it's second down. Back to throw. Finding Williams on the check down. Touchdown, LA! Kyron Williams. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Rams have taken a two-touchdown lead now. Well, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, but his top two options were not available on that throw, so he went the safe route. Worked out pretty well.
It was like you were in the pocket. How about you going through the progressions like that? But a lot of offenses say touchdown to check down. Look downfield first, bring it back to the line of scrimmage. Not easy for a rookie to do.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And that'll be caught by Kupp. And now off to the races, down the right side. Cooper Kupp, touchdown.
Cooper Kupp. Halfway to 100 now with career touchdown number 50. And the Rams get another third quarter touchdown to add on to that. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. He'll get it here on the jet sweep. Oh, and this one, it may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. The gun now on third down. Flushed out right. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Carter, even I can figure out who deserves the lion's share of credit for their lead right now, because he has been terrific in a dual threat role, really chewing up yardage and getting them points with his legs. Simply put, that defense has had no way of stopping him, and that's why his side is on top.
Up the middle, it's Williams.
Isaiah Oliver there on the tackle.
And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Williams going to get it again on second down. And a solid run here as he'll pick his way down to the 42-yard line. 97 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, partner, Marvin, our number one stats guy, just handed me a little card that says he has 97 yards on the ground today. You think he's going to get the ball again?
I think so. 3 away from that century mark, got to have it.
Yeah, and I think what they're going to call is one of his favorite runs, whatever he feels comfortable with, and what the offensive line has executed well today to try and get him over 100 yards.
They run it again with Williams. And he's got room. Now he's loose again, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Kyren Williams, 42 yards. And the Rams have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter.
So that drive there, CD, a good response, and that might be the one that gets him to the finish line, a comfortable lead.
Yeah, that's all about not letting the team back into a game, because they just gave up a touchdown. It was back to a two-score game, and anything can happen in that situation. But
let's go now.
They'll start this drive out on the ground.
It's a pretty strong running there as he'll take this across the 50 and down to the 44.
That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football, because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
They stick to the ground game on first down. It's Williams powering forward.
And now running right through it. And strong running here on the first two plays of the drive. He's got another first down on a gain of 12. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down L.A.
It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Now a 10th carry. Here's Williams. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Kyren Williams, 32 yards. And the Rams have opened up a 4-touchdown lead here in the fourth. So, Charles, the bad taste from that opening week loss, that's just a memory now. This has been a very strong performance as they score once again.
Yeah, I know.
And they take a knee. And they'll indeed take a knee. Charles, a lot of happy faces heading into the tunnel as this one ends. And understandably so, not only did they get the win, but boy, their offense was on fire in this ballgame.
And partner, I have no idea what the top speed is on one of those high-end sports cars. What's the top gear you can get into? This offense, they certainly were there in this one, huh? Everything clicking for them in this contest, the kind of performance that they're going to cherish.
So for L.A., there was a great all.